Welcome back to Nanning, where we've just seen an extraordinary display from 17-year-old Brian Yang to dismantle Bruce Leverday in straight games and give the Canadians a 2-1 advantage. Impressive sight at night, the Guangxi Sports Centre. So it's time for some women's doubles. Emily LeFell and Anne Chong face Rachel HONDERICH and Kristen Tai. We've been talking about that Brian Yang match for some while. What a future he has. Down to the women then, and certainly down to France's women, to keep them in the tie and keep their hopes alive of finishing top of Group 2. And this is a very, very hard match to call. Virtually nothing between them in terms of the rankings. Little more experienced, LeFell and Trot. But it's all about who can perform under pressure, especially the extreme pressure now that the French pair will be facing. Players on their way. This is, as I said, it's a fiendishly hard one to call. We'll have a look in detail at the profiles of these four women. Starting off with Emile LeFell, who's by a distance the most experienced player on the call. All the rest are 23, by the way. First French pair to medal at the European Championships, LeFell and Trot. Lons. They have been as high as 18 in the world, currently at 26, as you can see. And there's Antron from Nice-Saison. Won a European Championship silver, as I mentioned. She actually won the first national doubles title way back in 2013 as a very young woman. She's a pretty good mixed doubles player, too. Just there. Second outing together in this tournament. The other side of the net, Rachel HONDERICH. They're ranked at 32, so just 6 places lower. She actually had Achilles surgery a few years ago, Rachel. We won a tournament in Brazil this year. And her partner, Kristen Tai, born in Taipei, Chinese Taipei, lives in Vancouver. They've been the Pan Am Women's Doubles Champions for the last couple of years. They won an international event in, or she won an international event in Peru, singles at a very young age. She was only 17.
Ready to play.
And they have won all 3 of their matches, so I guess you'd call that an automatic pick. Bert van Heerenbeek from Belgium is in the umpire's chair. Jiang Xiying from China will be watching like a hawk as the service judge. Thank you. And just to reiterate here that the French have to win this match to take us to a deciding mixed doubles. Otherwise, we'll stop at the in the event of a French victory. So they'll have won by 3-1. Just remember to win Group 2 outright. Both these nations finished top of their respective subgroups.
Ladies and gentlemen, my right, Canada, represented by Rachel Hondrick and Kristen Tsai. And on my left, France, represented by Emily LEFEL and TRAN. France to serve, Antoine to Kristen Tsai. Above all, play.
So here we go. That was set back with interest by Kristen Tsai, right off the bat.
I think
Antoine was expecting that. Well, they should be fired up after Brian Yang's performance just now. If that doesn't get them going, then there's nothing will. Oh, what retrieving! More of that, please, and lots of it. What a rally! No wonder they're smiling. That they were dead there for a minute. Fantastic get from time. Brilliant. And that wasn't bad either from Honderich. In. There is just a wee bit of drift. I think that man just caught it.
One, two.
Oh, I think this is going to be a really, really entertaining match between these two pairs. Say the early signs of encouragement are encouraging. Something of an understatement. A better leave.
Serve, serve.
3-1. A bit frustrated there, Emily LEFEL. Couldn't have played those shots too much better. Kept coming back. In the end, I think she just rather snatched at it. Put the tape at the top of the net, came back. Just missed the sideline. And it was a completely unguarded area of the court as well.
2-4. Serve. 5-2.
Thank you. Honderich and Tai almost happy to kind of settle into playing more of a defensive game. Not because they're necessarily negative about the outcome, they just think it's the best chance of frustrating LEFEL and TRAN, and we've seen already how adept they are at blocking it. Really is something to behold. Just get the feeling that the French pair are starting to settle into this.
4-5.
First time that Rachel Honderich has really connected with one of those as she would want. Didn't waste much time for Brian Yang to join the rest of the Canadians, the front row of the cheering committee. The attacking, they failed to win the point.
8-4.
That was going well out, I think. ground her down, I think. The one thing I think that HONDERICH and TSAI just have to be careful about, fair enough having this kind of defensive tactic, and that's fine, but still got to remember there'll be opportunities to attack. You don't want to get completely ingrained in that mindset. So far, plan's working well at 9-5. Yeah, well done. They outlasted them again. Patience really is a virtue sometimes.
10-5.
74 shot rally. And if it comes down to a war of attrition, we've already seen that the Canadians will take some stopping. You just feel the French pair need to win some, well, a run of points, but need to win them with shorter rallies, because the longer these rallies go on, the more frustrated they're going to get, I think, as we saw a moment ago. So they'll go for the interval, the Canadian pair, with an 11-6 lead. Been fascinating viewing so far.
Just kind of watch that racket of theirs. And then some of the stuff that we come in and we do pushes, make sure we're also trying to hit that backhand.
Sometimes that you can do slow clear, but also you have to change speed. You can suddenly attacking clear to the center, or you want to change the pace, you side skip faster, then you do the points match. You point to the center, you more come closer. Hey, remember, because they are left hand side.
Left and right.
Every time you hit to the center, they are difficult, no matter which side that they are standing. Okay,
come on, keep it up. Well done, let's go.
20 seconds.
It's really interesting listening to the Canadian coaches there. I think that's a great shot, and that's what they want to see more of. When there's an opportunity to attack, do it. Don't get into this total defensive mindset. The other interesting bit of advice that you may well have heard if you were listening was about going down the middle with those attacking shots between LEFEL and TRAN.
Okay.
by Emily LeFell. A little wasteful.
8-14.
Better from Tran and LeFell. They actually outmaneuvered their opponents at that point. Ended up kind of covering each other rather than covering the court, the Canadian duo. Guarded area of the court. Stick ability, this Canadian pair.
17-9.
And very, very impressive fitness levels too. Because the amount of chasing they have to do, that's a great get. Albeit to no avail by Trump. Little run of points for the Canadians here.
18-9.
So one of the few loose shots that Hondrich has played. It's a very easy kill.
18.
At the net for LeFell. Yeah.
David Jerry-Fritt. 19-10.
Oh, that was going wide, I think. Great get by Honderich. The longer the rally goes, the more chance the Canadians have to win it. That's clearly the message. And here are 10 game points for Honderich and Tai. It, and I think you can say that was a tactical plan that worked to absolute perfection. 21-11, and Canada are one game away now from confirming their place as Group 2 champions.
Ok, les filles, on part à zéro. On part à zéro. Si vous êtes gêné de plus, là. Celle qui est au filet, on a du mal à faire quelque chose. D'accord? Vous êtes d'accord avec moi? Est-ce qu'on passerait pas d'abord par des attaques un peu plus excentrées? Utiliser le couloir quand toi t'es à droite et que tu veux croiser de l'autre côté là. Rester droit devant toi. Tu vois? Et après, sois prête sur le mi-court. Il faut plus qu'elle puisse jouer entre vous deux comme ça sans que vous leur fassiez mal. D'accord? Ce sera plus facile. Et aussi, ce sera plus facile pour Émilie, si ça joue à droite, pour celle qui est au final en général, d'intercepter le volant. Ok? Plutôt que de jouer vers le centre et après devoir faire droite gauche. Général, on reste sur le droit et vigilant sur le mi-court. Ça, c'est hyper important. On pourra faire mal du mi-court. D'accord? Parfois, quand on a décidé de rentrer dans les rallyes, on a fait beaucoup, beaucoup jouer Rachel. Si vous décidez de faire durer les rallyes et de faire bouger, faites que bouger Crystal. Rentrer bien sur les interceptions que tu fais au fil ou pas?
Ouais.
C'est pour ça je pense qu'il faut te reculer un petit peu. Là ça risque d'être un peu vite. Quitte à ce qu'elle bloque et que ce soit un bon choix au final. C'est pas très grave. Parce qu'il faut qu'on fasse mal. Il faut qu'on fasse mal. Tu vois, l'échange que vous avez fait à plat, à rentrer dedans, droite-gauche là. Faut pas hésiter à faire ça dedans.
D'accord?
Allez, fil. Allez, 0-0, on est parti.
20 seconds.
Well, although it looks like a very one-sided scoreline, 21-11, I don't think it'll take too much to potentially turn this round. Honderich and Tai need to keep doing what they're doing, and Tron and LeFel, if they just cut out the unforced errors, just a little run of points, a bit of confidence, a bit of inspiration from somewhere like that,
1-0.
Well, it's a bright start for the French pair. This is what I'm saying, they just need to keep this momentum up because I think they just got a bit down on themselves in the second half of that first game. Now they look at the scoreboard, see it's 3-love. And they know they can put HONDERICH and TRAN under pressure. Question is whether they can capitalize on that. That's a great get by TRAN. Too short, didn't get enough on that. Kirsten tight, and it got what it deserved for Man Tron.
4-2.
Quickly onto that though. That's good mental strength from Kristen.
3-4.
Straight back in business after maybe not the best of shots in the previous rally. Almost like the bite a bit because the French were having to defend for most part of that point.
Five,
was an error as well. And all of a sudden, the French are all over the Canadians now. So I didn't think it would take much to turn this round. Kristen Tai, but she'll take it. Very difficult when you're in a position where LEFEL was, relatively close to the net, and it's coming at you at that speed to try and make a judgment. Usually better off trying to play it. Couldn't have tried any harder. Keep the rally going. Power from the back of the court from HONDERICH. Missed it. Once again, they just outlasted them.
Seven, eight.
Another lengthy rally. A little careless, just can't afford to do that. They're under a lot of pressure in this second game. HONDERICH and Tai keep having to come back from behind. Every time they get close, the Canadians just go away from them again. That is a wonderful shot. Completely deceived both French women with that. All Antron's weight was going towards the left side, and the shuttle went the other. First time they've been in front in this game.
10-9.
Off the frame, but it worked. Good get by Tai. Very rare miscue. Wide, so a slender advantage for the Canadians at the mid-game interval.
The problem is that it stays on the right. I think that sometimes, when, for example, you're in front of Christelle, autant tourner at a moment donné si vous le sentez. Tapez fort, le même enchaînement, mais tapez fort sur Rachel. Okay, parce que sinon, ça va continuer à revenir là-dessus. Là, c'est soit on varie les angles, soit on varie et on change complètement aussi en croisé. Ce que vous faites là, c'est très bien. Ce que vous faites là, c'est très bien. On se crée des situations où on peut faire mal. Ok ? Il faut juste parfois être un peu plus patiente et parfois elles s'en sortent, c'est tout. Black, on continue à utiliser ce truc-là. Dès qu'on peut, on tape fort dans le revers de Rachel là-bas. Quand on est à mi-court, on pousse sur son revers. Elle ne peut pas faire autre chose que bloquer ou passer derrière. Ok ? Allez, fille.
Nip and tuck in this second game after the Canadians rather ran away with the first after a tightish opening. Great play from Trot. Good leave. They're going to challenge, though. It's got to be worth it. It's got to be worth it at this stage of the match. Remember, you get two challenges per game, and they have been used pretty sparingly. Out. Was out.
Challenge unsuccessful. One challenge remaining. 13-10. Link.
That looked like it was going wide the first one. They might regret that. That looked like it was going considerably wide. I think she might just have lost her bearings there, Kristen Tai. Suddenly, they look to have the ascendancy again.
17, Will.
Leaving that. Incredible. What a rally this is. Incredible. It doesn't get any more entertaining than that. 87 shot ready. At one point, Kristen Tai didn't have a prayer, and somehow she got the shuttle back. And in the end, eventually, they won the point. What a rally. I think everyone needs to catch their breath after that. Astonishing. Cut off by a chop.
Service over 13-18.
And this is where the Fel and Tron just have to believe. Forget the scoreboard. Just play it a point at a time. Just keep the faith. Plenty of games been won from 18-13 down. That's long. There's another point back.
14-18.
Sometimes after that massively long rally and all the emotion associated with it, it's hard to kind of refocus. That's long again.
15-18.
Massive point this. That's almost a criminal offence. Short on the serve. 19-15. I don't think they were never going to turn down. Still very much alive, this game, and the match, and the tie. And if they win this point and get to within two, there will be a lot of nerves out there. Gives the Canadian pair four match points.
Series open. 20 match point 16.
Couldn't get there.
Service over.
That was a chance too. 17-20. All over. It's a fantastic win for the Canadians. 21-17, and they're all on there. Michelle Lee and the rest. It took 50 minutes. A quite brilliant display by HONDERICH and TSAI, and in the end they just wore down LEFEL and TRAN. And that means they have secured the top spot in Group 2. Nervy at times in that second game in particular. I don't think anyone can dispute that Canada overall this evening have thoroughly deserved their victory in the tie by 3-1. That was the moment HONDERICH sealed the deal. And we're engulfed by their teammates, great to see. In these team events. So 21-11, 21-17, 50 minutes, and it means Canada top Group 2. Just confirming then everything we've seen tonight. 40 minutes it took Jiquel and Labar to get the better of Hoshu and Yakura. In the women's singles, well, it was an exhibition really. 22 minutes for the loss of just 11 points. Men's singles, Brian Yang, one of the performances of the tournament. He's only 17, and he made mincemeat of the experienced and 34th-ranked Rhys Leverday. But that was superseded, I guess, in terms of excitement at least, by Honderich and Tai beating LEFEL and TRAN in two games, and therefore sealing the tie for Canada. Let's just check on the draw for Group 1, because, of course, the trophy is going to be presented on Sunday. The quarterfinals finishing today. Victories for China, Thailand, Indonesia and Japan. So it's China-Thailand in the first semi and Indonesia-Japan in the second. They're both tomorrow. The final is on Sunday. Be sure to join us over the weekend then for all that action in the 2019 Sudirman Cup. That's what they're playing for. It's only 80 centimetres high, but it means the world. And not just to win that, but just to win even Group 2 as we saw tonight. From me, Trevor Harris, our whole team here, good night.